Hey guys, what is the Crackalackin? And today I am doing my very first power skilling video. And the person we are power skilling today is gonna be Captain America. And the version of Captain America we're gonna be power skilling today is gonna be the Marvel Cinematic Universe version. We'll be going over his AP, speed, and durability. First, we are starting off with Captain America's AP without the hammer. Now, it should be obvious that Captain America is above street and wall level. This is due because his performance against Ultron. In the scene of Age of Ultron, we can see that Captain America threw Ultron against a highway pillar. When calculated, the attack comes out at small building level. But we can get his attack potency much, much higher. In the final battle of Sokovia, when destroyed, it is calculated to be mountain levels of AP. We already know that Iron Man was there, but he didn't take the full-on attack. But he did take a decent chunk of it. And when calculated, the attack would be small town level durability for Iron Man. And in the movie Civil War, we saw a fight against Iron Man and Captain America. And we saw he was beating Tony at first. And the AI that Tony's suit had even said that he couldn't beat him in a hand-to-hand fight. And even after Tony countering his attacks, Cap was still able to beat him. And note, Cap's attacks were doing a lot of damage to Tony's suit, which in a prior film was able to handle a small town level attack. So overall, Cap's attack potency should be small building to small town level. And it should be noted that his attack potency should be equal to his durability. Now for Cap's speed. Now for me, I would place Cap at that massively hypersonic to relativistic speeds. This is due because he's able to keep up with one of Tony's suits, Mark 46, which is able to move at massively hypersonic speeds. And where the relativistic speed comes from is from Iron Man. This is due because he's able to dodge Iron Man's beams, which it is confirmed to be beams of light. Now with the hammer. So we already know that Captain America with the hammer should be significantly much higher than his base form. But how powerful is he with the hammer? In the film Endgame, we get to see a fight between Thanos and Thor. And it was confirmed that Endgame Thor is stronger than Infinity War Thor from Anthony Russo. So yes, Endgame Thor is stronger than Infinity War, surprisingly. And we saw that Thor was getting absolutely beaten by Thanos. And we saw that Captain America was able to hold out Thanos just for a bit. Note, scaling to Thanos in some way would be pretty crazy for the person that we're scaling for. And Captain America with the hammer should easily scale to a Phase 1 Thor, who in the first film was able to shake Jotunheim. And when calculated, the highest end for this attack would be large country level. And for me, I would agree on that. So overall, Captain America without the hammer should be small building to small town level with massively hypersonic to relativistic speeds. Now, Captain America with the hammer should be large country to probably continent level due to showing to get Thanos.
And that is the end of the video. I'll do way more of this stuff later on, but this is the video for today. See you later, guys. Goodbye.